We've heard four wonderful musicians, all very different styles. Thinking amongst yourselves the relative merits of Moisienko, we just heard, and Erno Kalai, the fiddle player from Hungary, and Mikhail Nemtsov, the Russian cellist, and Dominic Childs, the English saxophone player. What a wonderful range of music we've heard already, and still to come, two fine young pianists will be playing for us after the interval. First, from Spain, we'll be hearing Mario Mora Saiz, who is 22. He grew up in Cuenca. Cuenca is in the central part of Spain between Madrid and Valencia. He moved when he was just 18 to Madrid, to the conservatoire there, and now at the age of 22, he's studying for a master's degree at the Royal Academy of Music. I asked him why he'd chosen to come to London. The answer is the teacher who he'd met at a masterclass, Pascal Nemirovsky. It often happens that pianists and indeed singers and other instrumentalists will follow a great teacher, somebody who really captures their imagination, and that's what's happening with Mario. He's chosen a program of great contrasts. He's going to conclude with music by Isaac Albéniz. It's from Iberia, an evocation of Spain, which is generally thought to be Albéniz's piano masterpiece. This movement is called Malaga. It gives us a world of flamenco wrapped up in an astonishingly sophisticated musical language. Somebody once wrote that it requires a completely overwhelming virtuosity. Well, we'll see what Mario makes of that. First, he's going to perform two movements from an early sonata by Johannes Brahms, Opus 5, written when Brahms was only 20. And at the time when Brahms was struggling to forge his own musical language, rooted in Beethoven, in the face of the onslaughts, the romantic onslaughts of Franz Liszt and even Frédéric Chopin. And I think he can safely say to have succeeded, because Brahms was an astonishingly big personality, and he forced himself into the mold that he was looking for. The two movements that we're going to hear, the second movement actually has a text, a few lines from a poem, Der Abend dämmert, das Mondlicht scheint, evening twilight falls, moonlight is shining, wrapped in love's ecstatic dreams, two hearts are fondly beating. And there are two themes which is thought might be the two hearts beating. Very romantic for Brahms, who really is usually rather austere, never wrote an opera, but wrote lots of lovely love music all the same. And these two themes, one's Andante Espressivo, the other Andante Molto. And then in the third movement, number two of what we're going to hear, there's a big scherzo and trio. So it's going to be a fine display, first of Brahmsian classical romanticism in some kind of marvellous merger, which is what Brahms achieved, and then the out-and-out romanticism of Albéniz. So let's welcome now Mario Mora Saiz. we heard Mario that he said to me this afternoon, it's strange for a Spaniard to love Brahms so much, but I do. I want to play and record the complete works of Brahms. Well, he certainly set a high standard for himself with that performance. I'm very happy to say that Mario's father is in the audience, has come over from Spain to hear him tonight, and I hope he was as proud of his son as we all were at hearing him play so beautifully. It was a lovely performance.